Hello everyone. It's Monday, the 1st of November. The time is 10 a.m. and the temperature is 9 degrees. And in case you're wondering, the temperature change and the change of scenery is, of course, because we are in Finland. We are in Helsinki, just next to the railway station, main railway station here. This is the Sanomatalo, home to one of the biggest publishers in Finland. And this here is the Oodi Central Library, or I don't know, the Central Library. Actually, it is the city central library. And the plan today is to walk through some of the city center. Following an old railway line, which has been turned into a cycling path. That will get us to the seaside. Here's the Helsinki sign for start of the walk. Actually, should we go and have a look at the Helsinki sign? Seems like a fitting place to start. So here's the library. It opened in 2018. It's supposed to have robots inside fetching their books. I was reading about it. I've never been inside, actually. But it has a very striking architecture and has been sort of planned as a space for everyone to use. Meeting rooms, all kinds of spaces inside, but also the library. This is Sanomatalo here. Sanoma being one of the big publishers and owner of TV channels. That's the parliament. The boxy looking house on the other side, and I believe that's the new music center, also a recent addition to the other sort of well-known buildings around here. There's the ballet and the opera house and Finlandia house over to that side as you keep walking. But here's the Helsinki sign. The day is fairly overcast, a little bit of blue now. But this is what November looks like before you get snow often. Sometimes blue skies as well. There's a little bit of a breeze. Helsinki tends to be a bit colder than it sounds like because you have a breeze from the sea, or by the seaside. It's the capital of Finland, of course. More kind of very central at the moment. I haven't been in the capital since the pandemic started, really. So it's a very long break for me as well. And today's walk is inspired by my need to go and buy a new microphone. I'll pick it up. I already bought it this morning. And that's why we're doing a little bit of an unusual walk today instead of sort of going into the city center thing. I'll be doing a fair bit of walks around here, I'm sure. Have a couple of weeks when I'm mostly sort of in the area around the capital. Here's a better look at the parliament up ahead. I don't know. It's a sort of an iconic building, but I don't know, never liked it too much. place to start as any. So we're going on to, this is Mannerheim in there, by the way, Mannerheim's street. Mannerheim being one of the leaders, statesmen, and a military leader of his time. There's a statue which we won't see on this walk, I think, but just right by there. The Modern Arts Museum, Kiasma, is Kiasma, actually, if you say it in Finnish way. It's really difficult, actually, to change languages for me. I'm good with English and I'm good with Finnish, but it's the middle there which is kind of a challenge. So we're not going to the one of the main streets going through Helsinki here. We're actually going underneath to the old railway. This was open to pedestrians and cyclists. I'm just getting something from my back, by the way, wondering. So this was open to pedestrian and cyclist use starting from 2012, and it's called Baana, sort of a slang word, I guess, in Finnish for a way, street, or you could look at similar words in German, railway, Bahn, and then Swedish as well. Finland has two official languages, so some of the street names and some of the names you see around here are in Swedish or inspired by Swedish. And as you can see, Helsinki has trams. It's one of the forms of public transport. There's also an underground system, which is not very extensive at all. It has been extended a little bit recently, but it's not similar to many other cities. It's still fairly small. And buses, of course. We'll be kind of going through the city area this way, following Baana to an area called Jätkäsaari. Some advertisement for what's going on in the area around this time in the coming months. And these signs at the top are telling you which street you're passing, so you could go back up to find your way to where you need to go. Here's some cool street art. It's very dark though. I think the camera's picking it up. And this one of the usually the e-scooters. We have shared e-scooters that they get pretty much left wherever. They're all around town and on the streets as well. It's a big problem here for the snow when they try to remove the snow around Helsinki. And these things get covered underneath. I think that was sort of an issue last year. And if you're new to my videos, I tend to do daily walks around Singapore. And I'm visiting. I'm originally from Vantaa, Finland. Lived in the UK for over 10 years. I'm now visiting for a couple of months. This is also the first time that I'm walking and talking to myself without a mask. I think the mask is a nice thing to have for these walks. It's a little bit less outside in Finland. I think now the majority of people are not wearing masks. There's quite a lot of space to walk around, and there's no rule telling you to. So most people would not wear a mask outside. This is kind of for those of the people who are joining from Singapore to watch this. I really appreciate you guys tagging along. It's a little bit different. It's definitely a lot colder. I think from my very limited experience now, being on the train for 2 times from the airport and now the 15 minutes it took me to get to the city, I think the majority of people are still wearing masks on public transport. That's not mandatory, so you're being nicely asked to do it, but if you don't, there's no fine. There's no rule. It's more just quietly asking. There's a little snake over there hiding in the corner. Not a real snake. I guess the situation here is very different, in that not a lot of wildlife other than the Nordic kind can really survive over the winter. So lots of birds migrate, bears go and sleep and hibernate, so you're not going to see a huge amount of wildlife. Did see swans this morning. And the trees have already lost their leaves, so we're kind of into that late autumn or fall, and early winter soon. It's been a little bit warmer than usual, I think, and hopefully we'll still get snow fairly soon. It tends to get a lot nicer and lighter as you have the snow around here. Right now it's kind of grey. There's another wall art. So it's that nice time when it's actually kind of nice to be out. It's very fresh air, a little bit chilly, not too cold, but the trees do kind of look sad at this point before the snow. And there's still a little bit of green, so you still see the grass here, for example. It's a kind of mixed situation. These would be residential buildings mixed in with some offices on the side of the street there. I think we'll keep walking a little bit to Ruoholahti last day, I guess. Might be feeling those translations that are in no way official as we go along some of the streets. I'm not a tour guide, I'm just is someone walking around town. That's quite a nice shade of red there on the plants. So Helsinki is really a mix of old and newer buildings. Some areas will have all the architecture still. And then, of course, a lot of new residential buildings around the area we'll visit today is one that was developed quite recently. You might be able to hear a bit more noise as I walk around. I have to sort out the backpack and the coat issue. That's going to be audible on the videos. I'll figure it out. The new microphone should be good. I lost a couple of more audio tracks for these videos recently and got a bit bored of that. Another street art piece with some ships. Should be kind of fitting for the area we're coming to, which is by the seaside. It's very different in this kind of older towns, cities. There's the basketball court in the middle here. It seems like the sun might be making an appearance today. Of course, during the winter, there's not a lot of sunlight, not many hours. And the further you go, the less light there will be. Sort of further you go in the year, but also further you go in Finland, the northern parts will get almost no light at all. Don't get any light at all. So it's very different. Here are some different houses. You find a style like this around Helsinki as well. Areas of these wooden buildings. There's a bit of autumn colors still. We miss most of it though. wonder if these guys do like bicycle repairs. Looks like it in any case. It's a good place for it. It's a cycling path through Baana all the way through here. So here's more of a city view. This is the Ruoholahti area. Ruoholahti canal. There's the tram 7 that will take you to the ferry terminal. The other way though, to ferry terminal to take the ferries to Estonia, Tallinn. Seems to be a little cafe over here that I don't know, a restaurant. It's quite nice. I think it's made out of containers. So this area that we're going to from here used to be a container harbour before it was developed. Some old photographs in here. I think probably ads for a museum. Yes, the photography museum. There's the water side. We'll get to there. The sky's looking kind of interesting. And the residential area around here. This is where we have come from. It's 1.7 kilometers to the railway station, according to that sign. Just check that I'll take the right route to where I'm going. Also that there's no cyclists passing through. So the cycle path that we just walkthrough gets around 700,000 cyclists annually going through there. And this is the canal. So I think Wikipedia used the word or the translation of Docker Island for Jätkäsaari. Seems about accurate considering its past. Here's the Ruoholahti canal. And that area was developed from sort of 2008 onwards, so it's not a very old area. And it used to have four islands, and the land was filled between those to make up the area that it is today. Up on my phone that I'm going the right way from here. That's the kind of thing brought me to areas I'm not so familiar with all of them myself. I haven't been here for a while, so I need to look up where I'm going. I think this will take us through the Välimerenkatu. I think we could actually go to the seaside here. Some of the other areas, of course, are much more familiar to me, but not so much these new. Well, I say new. It's not new in that sense that it's been here for quite a while. But it is still a developing residential area. I was half anticipating and half not. I think I could have easily gone with a better scarf. Not good though. Characters lining the walkway here. I was hoping it had some information. It's just this, please don't climb. I think that might be for Supercell. They have their new offices around here. One of the things that I was anticipating and now see is happening is that the sun is really low, and that's going to be basically all the time I'm here, so we're going to be doing some dodging off the sun. I need to get behind buildings for that. map of the area. And of course the spelling, which we have, which is A with the dots, and O, which is the O with the dots. So that might not be something you're very familiar with.
It is the thing here though.
Well, these are some of the newer residential areas. So these would be mostly residential buildings around here with some restaurants and shops on the lower floors. Very cool bridge over there. It's especially around this time of the year when it's nice to have some color in the landscape. So this area is only served by the trams. There are no buses here. But there are four different lines that go from here at the moment. Parking complex called Rocky Parkki. I wonder if that's the stone. It could be the stone or it could be like rock and roll. There's quite a lot of Swedish text on the other side. I wonder if that's a poem. So all basically learn Swedish with some of us being more successful than others. It's very easy to forget over the years as well if you don't use it. But you'll hear announcements on the trams and the buses and trains and the public services have both languages. The Swedish speaking are a minority, so there are less of them. But then some areas are mostly just Swedish speaking, including the Åland Island or islands between Finland and Sweden. Yeah. cool little community garden. Of course, suffering a little bit of the weather by now. But I bet that would have been really cool during the summer. There's a new building going up on the other side. So this area very much still under development. It's kind of a yet soon. I can make my way towards the little park around this area. There's a sign for check in for the ferry to Tallinn. There, of course. Alright, I keep forgetting. So, actually, a car will stop for you in Helsinki. So, I keep standing by the pedestrian crossings and they keep stopping for me. I'll get it in a few days though, with a bit of walking. I'll make my way across like a normal person. So these trams basically all public transport serving this area. There's a ferry arriving or going. I guess it's the best way to the city, I guess. Over here. And then over there is Hyväntoinvonpuisto, which is a chapel. Good hope chapel. Information to me, but has to do with hope in any case. For all the vaccinations. Some people getting their third dose here. I think it's going to towards having 80% vaccinated. That's just looking to here. You see a lot of those buildings over there. Still kind of being finished. I think on our right will be the park. It's also a Hyväntoinvonpuisto. Good hope. I'll make my way through here. And then I think I'll finish this walk around the ferry terminal. a little bit green here. Colors on these residential buildings. So I'll make my way to the waterfront here. The cycling lane going through here as well. They're pretty cool looking. Children's playground with, I think that's a trampoline over there. That's fun. Turn here and well, there actually you can see the terminal over there, but I think there's no way through here. Oh, this is actually the school. Never seen that before, but that's the school. They seem to have quite nice sports fields around as well. I think that's an indoors football field. I need that kind of thing in this climate. And over there, the distance is the ferry terminal. So I hope you enjoyed this look around this residential area. And
the old railway, cycling way. It was kind of for my own purposes, so I can get to go and pick up my microphone. I'm a star. You're a Finn. You'll probably know where I'm going if you're familiar with Helsinki. But I think it's an interesting area to explore and one I wouldn't otherwise go to. So I don't know. On my way. This area very much still under development, and there's the terminal. Thanks for joining me on this walk from the city center, Helsinki, over the Jätkäsaari, through the Baana pedestrian cycling path. If you'd like to see more videos for a little bit from Finland through November and December, and then perhaps even from back in Singapore, then you probably know what to do. You can subscribe to the channel and be notified when there are new videos published. I'm going to go and pick up my new microphone, which will hopefully make the audio troubles a thing of the past. I think there's some kind of warship here. I think I read about it. Something to do with NATO. They got a helicopter on board. It's got a Canadian flag. I know there are a couple of people who have been watching in Canada. You are watching the double, you didn't expect to see that. That's kind of cool. Although it's, again, a war thing. I guess we could think of it as a sleeping thing as well. Still cool tech. I don't remember when I saw a helicopter up close like that. Not very close, but still definitely see it. And here's the whole ferry structure. I honestly didn't remember that the ships are here. That's pretty cool to just run into them like that. They even got the maple leaf on the ship structures. There's the helicopter, if you guys can see it. That's not a small helicopter either. I'm nearly where I need to be, so I'm going to thank you for joining again. That's where we came from. And this is the passenger terminal for the ferries in Western Harbour. is still another look at that helicopter there. So I'll definitely see you with new videos from Finland very soon, if that's something you're interested in. And I do hope that I'll see you soon.